Revs coming up. We're green.
Big boom coming off the three.
Two, three, four abreast in some spots.
Side by side action.
He absolutely nailed it.
Three-way battle.
And we've got an incident. You would expect nothing less.
Oh, clips the inside apex.
Very racy.
This is going to get interesting.
That is a brave move. What a pass. This is what World Challenge is all about.
Welcome to Tooele, Utah, just west of Salt Lake City and the desert vistas of Mile High Miller Motorsports Park for the Nissan Championship Finale brought to you by Motul. Hi, all. I'm Greg Kramer, and I'll be heading to the booth and my regular broadcast partner, Calvin Fish, in just a minute. But first, this historic season has not only celebrated this series' past, it has defined its future. As a result, in 2015 and beyond, there's plenty more excitement to come. But this weekend is all about wrapping up what have truly been some spectacular point fights in both of our divisions.
It is now time to get this one underway. To do that, we head down to the front of the grid for that special command.
On behalf of Optima Batteries, Pirelli Tire, and Nissan, drivers, start your engines.
The back of the grid is clear, so now we watch for the lights. As always, when they come on, as they have, when they go out, we are underway. We're green!
And Skeen, no! Skeen has his move! Vicky as well.
The pack. Two of the Kias are involved, as well as the number 28 of Mike Cooper filling in that Black Dog Chevy for Gables.
Look,
oh, my
O'Connell
goodness.
On the outside. O'Connell from 8th on the grid looking for the lead. What
O'Connell
is that in this race?
In a second. Oh, way out to the right side. And Dial, we're on board with Dial. He slips into third. What a start by O'Connell, but what drama for Skeen. And look at pole sitter. Smith has dropped way back to 6th or 7th, Cal.
Yeah, the Bentleys didn't have the best of starts, but what a start for Robert Thorne here. He's taking the lead. DL to the inside of O'Connell as they head down to the Black Rock hairpin.
Boy, did he get a great run through those sweepers. He's through, slots into 2nd, and there are those two Bentleys, both of them dropping back. And Thorne from 4th into the lead for Capex. That's an amazing story. And here we are. This is on board now with Jack Baldwin, who's now the leader after all the drama for the Kias.
Yeah, can you believe that? I mean, Wilkins grabs the pole, and now there's contact between those two. Something happened there. I'm not sure if there was some kind of starting issue. And obviously, Nick Jansen was lined up directly behind Mark Wilkins there at the start. So you'd have to think maybe Wilkins had an issue, and Nick couldn't avoid him. We'll have to wait for a replay.
Yeah, unbelievable what's unfolding here in terms of the championship implications. Boy, we had everything turned on its head last year, the second to the last round of the championship in Sonoma. Let's take a look at what happened. Go back and see if we can suss everything out. First of all, from the back, ooh.
Oh, you can see it there. Nick Jansen just tags Wilkins, who didn't look like he went anywhere. Then he's narrowly missed as well by another Mustang.
Now we're on board with Nick.
Looked like you missed him with the front end, but he kind of got a little bit sideways and collected it with his right rear corner.
On board here with Cooper, and here
comes
Smith.
Oh, he had nowhere to go.
And here's the look from the back of Skeen. As you can see, he's got power. It's revving and going nowhere, Cal. Oh, look at the frustration.
Yeah, I think he's broken a half shaft or something, Greg.
Unbelievable what's unfolding. So after basically a lap, here caution, here's a look at the top four in each of our two classes. We'll be right back. Welcome back to our Nissan Championship Finale at Miller Motorsports Park, brought to you by Motul, 15th round of the Pirelli World Challenge Championships. We're coming back to green after 5 laps under caution for the cleanup, but now it will be a single file rolling start. That's going to negate any opportunity for that launch for those Cadillacs, and I would suggest some of these turbo guys ought to have a pretty good run. Speaking of which, look at the move by Guy Smith down to the inside in the Bentley.
Wow, he gets around, I think it's Andrew Palmer there for the 4th spot, 5th spot. Caddy's running 3 and 4 right now, so they don't have the initial launch, but they've still got a little bit of grunt as they head down to turn 1 in our Motul braking zone.
That was one of the things the caddy driver said might actually keep them in play here, was they do have good top end at the end of long straights.
Big move by Smith. He's up to 4th already. Pole sitter on his way.
Boy, yeah, they're just frustrated with the launch, obviously, but those Bentleys are so quick and able to get back after it. Both drivers have also said those cars are really good on their tires, so as the race gets deeper, they think they might get even stronger. Here's Butch Leitzinger trying to make a move. Big defensive move there by Andrew Palmer, and look at that move down to the inside.
Boy, he made that look easy.
Man.
I mean, Smith had pace in qualifying. He's showing it here on this green flag restart as well.
This is through that Black Rock hairpin. Now they do this double apex right-hander and then that very fast sweeper that leads them into the attitudes. What an absolutely great venue here. What a field. Sitting in 4th now, Johnny O'Connell, Skeen,
nowhere yet. They've taken that car back to the garage to try and get him out, and he's got his wingman right behind him. This is about as perfect a scenario as you could envision, one that if you scripted it, nobody would believe.
And you got to think about that manufacturer's chase as well. Caddy come in here chasing Audi, and right now it's Andrew Palmer who's the best-sitting Audi in sixth spot right now, so Caddy's could have a big day.
Absolutely. This is the GTS battle. That is Nick Asayan, folks, and the natural Kier's Aston Martin behind the legend Jack Baldwin. And those Aston Martins just seem to, one, really run well here. And Asayan, who's dealt with a lot of bizarre electronic glitches in that car all season long, clearly it's come good. But with Drew Riggetts right there as well, this Aston Martin team is, as you said, Cal, looking really good.
They're looking really good. Here we see Alex Figge now finding his way back through this field after that initial stall or initial launch issue. So they were looking at Nick Asayan. As you said, very frustrating season for Nick. A lot of electrical gremlins really prevented him from showing his stuff. But right now, if he gets up to Jack Baldwin, you know he's going to be hungry. Look for his second win in World Challenge.
Watching Figge as we ride on board with both Figge and Baldwin. Boy, I love these GoPro shots, the way that it just lets you see how everything's unfolding from the driver's eye, and that was Figge just working through. Gives you an idea of the difference in speeds between the GT and GTS classes.
Yeah, there's a big speed difference, but the guys are playing together nicely. Baldwin leads here, and he's a man who's got a little bit of momentum right now, got some speed in that Porsche, and he'll know that the Kias have had trouble. He's going to just dig deep, score as many points as he can. He is still an outside threat for this championship, depending on what happens to Aschenbach, of course.
Yeah, he's got that reset MD Porsche Cayman absolutely dialed right now. Having a look at some of the battling back in the 7th, 8th position, there's Anthony Lazzaro. Here's a look at our class leaders in each of our three classes. Round 15 of 16 for the Pirelli World Challenge, the Nissan Championship finale at Miller Motorsport Park, brought to you by Moat Tool continues. Jack Baldwin continuing to lead Nick Asayan in the GTS battle, opened it up by maybe two car lengths since we broke away. And folks, as we went to break, you saw that it was Tim Pappas leading in the GTA subcategory. While we were at break, pulled into the pits, apparently a drive belt issue. Looks like his day is done.
Well, that's really too bad. The car had a lot of form here this weekend. Thomas Jaeger, who's the AMG factory driver, was over assisting Tim in setting up that race car, had a lot of pace here.
Boy, and this battle just coming into frame. There it is. That is Lawson Aschenbach in that Black Dog Speed Shop Camaro working over Alec Udell in that Mustang. That's the Watson Racing machine. This is huge with the Kia issue. This, every one of these passes he can make is mega.
Well, I'm sure his engineer, Mark Wider, will be on the horn saying, you've got a lifeline here. The Kias are out. We're understanding that Kinetic are really working feverishly in the paddock right now to try and get those Kias back on the racetrack. You've got to do 70% to get points here today, but most importantly, the grid for the final race tomorrow is set for your fast lap today. Right now, those Kias don't have a time on the board.
Yeah, same thing with Mike Skeen and the CRP boys are working feverishly on that axle as well, as we are looking back now at the nose of Lawson Aschenbach, and that is a nose that's leading to a very hungry driver. In front of these two is Jack Roush Jr. right there in that multicolored Roush Racing Mustang. So those are the two drivers that right now Aschenbach has his eyes on. We hop on board now with Guy Smith and that resurgent drive up. Ooh, and he easily just kind of blows by the
almost
outside.
Too easy. Ryan Diallo held down. That second spot seems to be slowing a little bit as Smith just blows by him. Look how much he's stretching it immediately.
Yeah, I mean
that. Oh, yeah, DL's in trouble. Look at this. Yeah. Caddies are coming as well.
Yeah, he lifted way early. Something is very wrong. Both caddies slide through, and he's really struggling to even keep it on track at this point. Well, that would make you wonder if he doesn't have some sort of a suspension issue or a tire puncture, something
yeah,
along those lines.
He's just trying to stay out of the way. Yeah. He realized he can't defend. Man. Something's amiss, which is a great shame because he had a strong run here, putting the pressure on Thorne all day.
But, of course, for the two Cadillacs, they're going to be liking that in terms of championship implications. And that's really got so much focus here, doesn't it?
And also, when these Bentleys running so well, they're also pads it back to the first of the Audis. So this is big news for Cadillac coming in here, trying to chase down Audi in that manufacturer's chase.
Boy, and now that Guy Smith is unleashed, let's see if he can run down Robert Thorne. Talk about the veteran running down and going after the up-and-coming star, and a McLaren leading a Bentley in front of two caddies. You gotta love this.
You gotta love it. For guys, his 40th birthday, so I'm sure he'd like to celebrate nothing more than to get a victory here today. He's been part of the victories over in Europe with this Bentley team, so he knows what makes this car tick, and I think he feels he's got a really great car underneath him here today.
Let's go back on Aschenbach on board, and look at this. This GoPro camera is certainly showing us that he and Udell have run down Jack Roush.
They have, and I tell you what, Lawson Aschenbach, just give him a sniff. He's going to chase you down. He just wins championships after championships. He knows that Wilkins in trouble here today, the guy he's got to chase down in this title fight. So he's going to try and get every point he can here today. These positions are critical for Lawson Aschenbach.
Well, we're going to step away for a minute. Here is your top four in GT. Thorne trying to hold off Smith in the championship battle there in third, and Baldwin leads in GTS. Back at the Nissan Championship finale, brought to you by Motul. We were on board here with Alec Udell, and that's a big move there. Not only did Aschenbach get through, but Vesco Kozarov, remember, started from pit lane in that Nissan Skullcandy 370Z, that team debuting in the GTS category here this weekend. What a run by Vesco.
It really is. This is a great little team. They've had a lot of success in other series, but right now on debut, what a mark he is making. Really shaking things up in the top five.
And the big story, though, is right in front of him is Aschenbach, who got through on Udell before Kozarov started this attack. That was huge.
It's huge because every point is so critical. I mean, Wilkins is still in the paddock. They've not got that Kia fix. We understand that Nick Johnson's car is very close to seeing some action. He isn't going to make the 70% mark, get points today, but the key is, again, fast lap today sets you good for tomorrow. If they can't get Wilkins back out there, he'll have to start at the back of the pack tomorrow.
Yeah, huge implications. And let's not forget, still leading here is Jack Baldwin. And that has an opportunity. He's mathematically in it, too, and closing that gap up.
Yeah, he came in here about 200 points behind. But let's not forget, there's over 300 points on the table here with the doubleheader. So everything's still to play for, remarkably.
Yeah, and this battle, look at this. Roush in that multicolored Mustang. Aschenbach in the Black Dog Camaro. Kozarov in the Skullcandy Nissan. Udell in the Watson Racing Mustang. And there's a couple more guys behind him. This is some absolutely fabulous racing. Yeah, it's not for the win in GTS, but it is absolutely superb stuff. And a couple of Aston Martins. I think that is Drew Riggins in the mix, too.
Yeah, he's in there. He obviously qualified up in the top five. He's dropped. Oh, drama. That's the leader.
That's Thorne.
Thorne's involved.
Brad Adams. Oh, my. Traffic. We've seen it happen. Ooh. And there it is.
Went for a hole that probably wasn't there, Greg. And Guy Smith was starting to heap the pressure on.
I think that's it. He felt the pressure from Smith, didn't he? And tried to rush it. Yeah, just not quite there.
He was banking on Adams, haven't seen him, and allowed it to slide through the inside. And
another look from Adams in his GoPro camera, and you can see.
Yeah, he just gets turned, so.
You know, and Thorne's struggling to get going again, so that should put Smith out front, but more importantly, yes, there's Johnny O'Connell
wow.
Now second. Boy, this script again. If you wrote this for Hollywood, they'd look at it and go, now this is too unbelievable.
But I tell you what, Johnny O is driving better than he ever has.
Oh,
I think
seriously.
This year the challenge from these GT3 machines has really put the pressure on Cadillac and the whole team, Johnny O and Andy Pilgrim, to step up their game. They're not getting the normal win totals that they expect, but boy oh boy, big points week in and week out. Had a little BOP change, a little bit less weight on that caddy after the heat that they got after Road America. So they got a little bit more performance here, but I think they thought a top five would be good. Right now he's running second.
Now the next group of cars they're going to catch is that pack from third on to eighth in the GTS division. So opportunity there. Well, you never know. We'll come back and find out. Stay with us. Racing continues here in the Nissan Championship finale at Miller Motorsports Park, brought to you by Motul. 15th round of 16 in the Pirelli World Challenge Championships. This GTS battle has been extraordinary, but notice right behind Jack Roush is the number 41 effort racing Porsche, Mike Mills. He is currently leading in the GTA category. If he can hang on and win this, that's pretty much going to put him in the complete driver's seat to clinch the first ever BRM Chronograph Sportsman Cup Award for this new category for our sportsman drivers. On board now, Andy Lee, again in that Laguna Bikes Crown 7 Lamborghini that he's running, invisible glass wiper blades as well. That was in a grow, and he gets it. That was Baldwin, I think, Cal.
That was Baldwin. That's our GTS leader. The key is, where is Nick Asayan? Is he close enough to take advantage?
Oh,
and he's stranded there on the racetrack. He's fired up again.
He's able to get it going, but there is, look at that, is Nick Asayan. He is now your leader. Baldwin has dropped back as a result.
Wow.
Asayan was close enough. Here's another look at it.
This is the same corner, I think, where Thorne got into Adams, so it's inviting to tuck down the inside, but when someone's going for the apex, they're not really expecting it. See, he lets Palmer through. didn't expect Lee to make the same move.
There it is. That white Aston Martin right there is a huge story. Drew Riggetts online to get his first ever podium. But this move, here's a replay, Lawson Aschenbach, that's huge, Cal.
It is huge, and they really got that Camaro working really well. It's very compliant. He ate a lot more of that curb there through the previous corner, allowed him to get that inside shot on Jack Roush Jr. And as we said, these points are super critical.
Yeah, back on board now with Jack Roush Jr. looking ahead as he's got company right behind him from Mark Clennon, by the way. And if Clennon could stay up here, it'd be his career best finish ever. So these Aston Martins really on form here as we take a look at Aschenbach.
They certainly are. But one key development in this race, as you look up ahead of the racetrack right now, you'll see a Kia of Nick Johnson is bad on the racetrack. And he has just laid down the fastest lap in the GTS class. It gives Kia a point here today in the manufacturer's chase. Also gives him the pole position if no one goes quicker before the end of the race for tomorrow's finale. Huge news.
I'll tell you, just watching Guy Smith, I mean, you know, considering this is only his third race, you take a look at the speed he's shown in these cars, pretty impressive. You look at his numbers for three races so far.
And it's great to see him having success with the Dyson team, who he's enjoyed such a fabulous career here in the States with. So he's very comfortable in the team. Peter Weston, the engineer he's worked with for many years, and he and Butch are going to be formidable, particularly if they come back next year and make it for the championship.
Well, I mean, Dyson is a team that has longevity not only in its crew members but its drivers that is really unheard of. You look at Guy's career, but Butch's career with that team, unbelievable. And here comes Guy Smith, speaking of which, and the white flag flies. We are starting our final lap of this 15th and penultimate round of the championship. And look at Butch closing on Johnny O'Connell. This last lap, this is going to be furious. And remember the championship implications. Guy Smith is gone at this point. That battle for second is huge.
It is huge, and Johnny's going to have to dig deep and use every ounce of his years of experience behind a race wheel right now to try and hold on to that position, because it's a big gap between second and third in the points standing. So he wants to hold on to that, knowing that tomorrow's going to be a big day. If he can hold on to this, we'll have to look at the math, but he may have even clinched here today. But Butch is coming, and he is coming fast.
Yeah, here's Guy heading down to the Black Rock hairpin. And there we go.
Oh, he's
Butch
to the outside.
Boy, he got a run, and O'Connell had he had no choice but to defend to the inside.
Yeah, I think O'Connell was already running down the left side of the racetrack when he exited turn four.
Hop on board here with Jack Roush Jr. Late day. Look at the sun coming through the windshields. On board now with Alec Udell. These GoPro cameras, unbelievable, as he sits in the sixth spot right behind Roush as they head down into a very tricky complex of corners here, Cal.
Well, they call it Sunset Bend for a reason, and that's why late in the day you can see how it settles there as the guys are searching for that turning point. But look at this battle, half a lap to go. Can Johnny O hang on?
Boy, Butch is searching. He's searching for any way through as they come up now to Tuella Turn, turn number 10 on the outer loop course here. And heading down, this is Randy Pilgrim said there's a potential passing zone, and Butch is showing the nose. He's going to try, and O'Connell turns in just a little bit early and see if he can hang on here in the final couple of corners.
Yeah, Johnny just floated a lot of speed through there. I don't think that was a real hard attempt by Butch Leitzinger, just trying to rattle Johnny O, but that's not going to happen. He tries to set him up for an over-under, but that caddy's got good, strong speed.
Yeah, but if he can get a better run out of the street as the checker flies, Guy Smith getting Bentley's first win, Dyson's first win. Wow! A matter of feet, Cal, that Johnny O is able to hang on to second place, and more importantly, second place points.
Wow, huge day for Bentley. Get the win. They're first in the championship, a 1-3. Two guys on the podium. But this is the huge story right now. Who would believe that Johnny O would finish on the podium? Skeen wouldn't get a top finish.
There's Mike Mills coming through, getting the GTA win. Just a phenomenal day for him. That's going to put him in absolute control in that GTA championship
five
for
in
the
a
sportsman
run.
Division. Yeah, just absolutely amazing. And Nick is saying, hangs on in the Natural Cures TRG AMR Aston Martin.
That is
what
really
a story.
Cool. Yeah. Really, really cool. Jack there in second, so his championship hopes are up for tomorrow. Look at this.
That was a bump right there. Udell going around the outside, now trying the inside. They touched once. Might be a little touch there. Watch Clennon. That's the Aston Martin.
Yeah, he's going to get a run here on the front straightaway as a horsepower run to the line.
Oh, this is going to be so close. It's Roush just over Udell. And Clennon, I don't think he was even half a car length adrift. So that's a career best finish right there for Clinton. Absolutely amazing. And by the way, Mike Skeen did get out. He did get 70%, so he won't get any points, but he got a lap that will put him somewhere in the top 10.
Yeah, and that's going to be key, but tomorrow just keeps that championship. Maybe door is still halfway open.
Absolutely. Here are our results. Guy Smith getting the win, but Johnny O'Connell, second place points. Leitzinger completes the podium. That's a big story. Look at this. Alex Welch, he's occasional driver with GMG in GTA, gets his first career podium in that category. Second in the points, Henrik Hedman back and forth. And then here you see the problems for some of the players, particularly Mike Skeen, not in terms of points, but he got a lap and Tim Pappas out after leading in GTS. What a story for Sam.
This is fantastic. I mean, Nick is such a cool guy. He's been a huge supporter of the championship. Two Aston Martins on the podium. Aschenbach, big points there today with Wilkins in trouble.
Guy Smith, first win for Bentley. Happy birthday.
Thank you very much. Yeah, it's I'm maybe getting older, but I quite like being 40. It seems to be a good age for me. I'd just like to thank all of the Dyson Racing team and Bentley for giving us such a great car. It was great this morning in practice and in qualifying, and I tried to get out front and try and, you know, see if I could sort of stay out there, but we made our customary terrible start and we managed to come back from it, so it was a good race.
Here is a look at Nick Hassan. What a run he put in today on his way to his first win in the series since 2010. A great day.
First off, I'm sorry that Jack's race ended that way. You know, we got clipped. I really didn't have anything for him, but pressured him, continued on. For all the people after 9/11 yesterday, our hearts are out with you as long as your hearts are with us too here. Appreciate everything that everyone in the military does as well, so thanks for that. But tough race today, so this is for everybody that's out overseas.
Our Motul fast laps of the race, Guy Smith, another pole in that Breitling Mobil 1 Bentley, and Nick Janssen coming back out to notch the pole and a key manufacturer point as well. As we are looking there at Mike Mills, well, I'll tell you, what a day, but we've got another round, the season finale, round 16 coming up. When we come back, do not go anywhere. This is it, folks. The final round of the 25th anniversary season, the Nissan Championship Finale at Miller Motorsports Park, brought to you by Motul. Championships are going to be decided, and the scenarios here, Cal, are insane.
Well, Johnny O should have this title wrapped up. He's got 152-point lead, so unless he gets a penalty today, he should get his third crown. But in GTS, it is really tight. Wilkins now has just a 2-point lead coming in here with an 80-point lead yesterday and all of the drama that we saw unfold. So it's really mano a mano between Ian and Aschenbach. But if both those guys had problems, Jack could still sneak in for that title.
Absolutely. And in manufacturers, Audi and Cadillac dead even. So whichever one finishes in front is going to clinch. Kia leads by 7. Ford could get it if they win and neither of the Kias score any points, but they have to win. This is going to be fascinating when those lights go out. This final race of the season is underway. Watch for it, we're green, and again, Smith a problem, and a great start by D. Allen Thorne.
Thorne got away cleanly. DL got a big one to the outside, but a bobble there for Guy Smith. You can see the rest of the field just goes around him.
He's still struggling in the middle of the pack.
He's got no pace there.
Something's more wrong. And
look at O'Connell again. He looks to the outside. Then on a Motul brake zone. Look for the way around the outside, the long way around. Thorne, can Thorne defend? They touch. Unbelievable stuff. DL slots into third. Pilgrim fourth.
And again, O'Connell still not giving up. Finally.
Look at Skeen on Pilgrim. This is massive.
This is huge coming up. So it's Thorne. That little bit of a touch. O'Connell tucks back in behind.
Big start for Skeen.
Wow.
Big start for Skeen from eighth up to fourth. Now he defends on Pilgrim going down to the break zone for BlackRock. Pilgrim comes back at him.
Boy, darn, that was three abreast down into BlackRock. Look at Dial absolutely all over the back of O'Connell already.
Look at that. Pilgrim is really fighting hard here. He knows how important that battle is with Mike Skeen. They cannot afford to be behind that Audi at the end of the day. Otherwise, the championship title is gone for the manufacturers.
Skeen is through. Skeen has made it through on Pilgrim. Pilgrim shows the nose, tries to come back, and he got him again. Wow, that was a great run out of that turn by Pilgrim. He slots back, but
wow,
now Skeen
awesome.
Down to the
this
inside again.
This is fantastic again. Stuff. Two guys putting it all on the line.
They know what this importance level is. This is huge for the manufacturers and all the investment they put in. I mean, Johnny O'Connell is out front in the caddy, but there's a lot of race yet to go. This is by no means settled. Alex Figge finally getting a decent start. See if he'll become a player in this.
Cesaro right there, he needs a big day. That battle for third spot in the championship is tight right now between he and Pilgrim, but for the second day in a row, it's Robert Thorne who leads this field back to the stripe.
Remember, Thorne was in a comfortable, semi-comfortable position and then got into some GTS traffic. Have to see if he can avoid that today. And for Anthony Lazzaro, you mentioned it. He said after his race yesterday, it was the worst car he's had all year. As we go back to another look at the start, and nowhere for Smith.
No, he just didn't get going. And then it's like he's got some kind of problem here, Greg, because he doesn't get going. He balks a little bit, but then look, just cannot get that Bentley up to speed.
Yeah, absolutely nothing on him. We're on board with Mills, and he goes screaming by the number 88 there, and he's being very careful because Mills can clinch that Sportsman Cup if he just earned some points today, so he's going to be super careful.
Yeah, he's coming off five consecutive wins in a row, but if he doesn't finish here and doesn't get any points, that title could be stolen away from him.
Boy, and look at Dial hounding Johnny O'Connell. I'm sure Ryan feels some unfinished business after having had great speed yesterday and then having what was, it all started with a puncture, but they also determined that they had a clutch issue.
O'Connell's wide there. Ooh. He left the door open a little bit. Couldn't get that caddy turned in, it looked like. And meanwhile, up front at GTS, Janssen's doing the job here, leading Jack Baldwin right now in the early going.
And of course, Aschenbach right now, he just needs to finish in front of Mark Wilkins. Here's your leaders in the GT category, and the lead in GTS is under contest. We'll be right back. Mark Wilkins is on a charge here in the final round of the Pirelli World Challenge Championships. The Nissan Championship finale brought to you by Motul from 17th to 6th. Cal, he is flying right now.
Oh, he's wide.
He's way wide. He's slow.
There's smoke. Unbelievable. Just as he'd made all of that ground up, he is now plummeting down the field. And this is on board now with Jack Baldwin as he attacks Janssen in the other Kia for the lead.
Boy, this is, we saw Jack make an attempt earlier. He didn't get through, but he comes through easily. And there goes Kozaroff as well. Janssen
is he in
trying
trouble?
To counter, comes back out. Boy, he doesn't accelerate that well out of that turn, Cal.
Can you believe on the same lap, both Kias are having trouble. And for Wilkins, that is huge. He has lost many, many positions.
Well, Janssen tiptoeing, and Aschenbach now all over the back of him. And Janssen's very slow by comparison, isn't he?
He's got trouble.
Unbelievable.
Let's think about this. For Drivers' Championship may be a big problem right now for Wilkins, but for Kia, can they hang on to this manufacturer's title? Got to look for that first Ford. If Ford can win here today with Kia out of the points, they can snatch it away.
Yeah, and the question is can either Janssen or Wilkins hang together long enough to salvage anything? Haven't heard yet what those issues might be over the radios. We'll certainly let you know when we do, but Janssen clearly off the pace. Wilkins is in, and you can see steam coming under the hood. So, I mean, something in terms of overheating here. There is your overall leader, Robert Thorne, in the K-Pax McLaren. Can he hang on today? Well, we hope so. Here's a look at your class leaders in each of the three classes. We'll be right back. In the Nissan Championship finale at Miller Motorsport Park, brought to you by Motul, our final round of the championship. And Johnny O'Connell sitting in third with Andy Pilgrim right behind him. But right behind Andy is Mike Skeen. And although Johnny's pretty much got the driver championship clinched, that two Cadillacs and that Black Hawk Performance Audi, that is your manufacturer's championship battle. Really couldn't be closer.
It couldn't be any closer. And Mike Skeen gets great launch there coming on this front straightaway. So Pilgrim has got his work cut out. And if he gets by him, he's got to try and get by Johnny O as well. They're going to do everything they can to get the manufacturer's title for Cadillac here today. It's going to be tight. Lazzaro's right there now, starting to put the heat on Mike Skeen a little bit as well as we head down to our Motul break zone.
And keep in mind that Kia limping around, that is Janssen. He's almost at the back of the GTS field. Manufacturer championship implications there as well. It's opened that window up for Ford if they can find something here later in the race. And now these two caddies in that group coming up on traffic. And take a look at this here. Big move by Skeen trying to make the move on Pilgrim. And he's got Lazzaro all over the back of him.
Yeah, he's got to be careful here as he's trying to make a move on the Cadillac. Oh, someone's out wide. Look at Lazzaro. Dives to the inside. He has that move done.
Wow.
Deep on the brakes.
But Skeen going to stay on his outside shoulder, Cal. Try, if he can stay put, he's got the inside for the next turn. Can he? No, Lazzaro clears him. Oh, but Skeen just rockets up. There was no room to make that happen,
that
and he found a gap.
Cool. That was really cool. And Lazzaro has an incentive. He has to try and get by Pilgrim. He's trying to get that third spot in the championship, remember, and he's dicing out with Andy Pilgrim for that.
Look at Nick Janssen. He is now crawling, and we do have a report for him. Apparently, it too is a half shaft issue, and we got word, as we could see, but it was confirmed, Wilkins overheating.
Overheating. He spit a belt on the engine, and immediately that engine caught some high temperatures, so just devastating day for Mark Wilkins.
Boy, and look at this battle that's starting to shape up. DL now has closed it up onto the back of Thorne, and there is nothing between these two cars, the McLaren and the Porsche, the GT3 machines, added at the front.
He has got a lot of pace. He's doing a tremendous job. The question is, can he resist the pressure from DL right now?
Absolutely, and here's how it looks, your top four in GTA. Currently GTS, led by Baldwin. We'll be back. Jack Baldwin leading the Nissan Championship Finale at Miller Motorsports Park, brought to you by Motul in his Reset MD Cayman. This is huge in terms of points. The way things look right now, he might be able to steal second away from Mark Wilkins. Boy, what a tough weekend for Wilkins. But he's got, I'm talking about Baldwin here, he's got to worry about that Nissan coming up behind him. That's Vesco Kozarov in that Skullcandy Team Nissan entry, who's flying as well as we hop on board with Ryan Dial.
Well, this is a battle for the lead, and talk about pressure. Robert Thorne had it yesterday from Guy Smith, and right now he's got DL all over him. He's not letting him go. The car looks good. He's been doing a great job. Can he hang on?
Well, the interesting thing, I mean, he's a young up-and-coming driver. The guy behind him, I think, is one of the world's best sports car racing pilots, period. So this is going to be tough. By the way, that blue number 11, oh! That's Brad Adams, and that's Tony Gables, as you said. I was just about to say that. It's weird to see him in a blue Mustang here, but he and Adams get together.
Who dat? That Tony Gables.
Wow, he came from way, way back. Yo, got him. Oh, my. That's just listen to it. Yeah, he just clocked it, didn't he?
That was a little bit of a late move there, so I'm not sure if something was amiss there with Tony, but certainly turned Brad in a big way.
Yeah, well, it's, again, unfamiliar maybe with that car and some of its late race tendencies, you never know. But boy, this is just some amazing stuff.
Yeah, really rolled some speed through that corner. Thorne is going to have to defend here because DL wants the win.
Down into the clubhouse turn. Now into this section. This is called wind up. And DL shows the nose.
Yeah,
got
Porsche
him offline a little bit, didn't he?
He really does. He is working him over right now. This is like a prize fight.
Now it just comes down. This is a two-thirds of a mile front straight. This is all about just flat-out speed.
It really is, and DL is tucked up under there. He's going to get that slipstream advantage we discussed, but he doesn't seem to really get an advantage from that. Really just keeps it even, and Thorne's really good on the brakes here. So this is tough, and I think as the laps wind on, Robert Thorne's going to get a bit more confidence, realizing that maybe, just maybe, he can keep Ryan DL at bay. Just sensational to allow these cars into this category. Such diversity with the various manufacturers. Exotic race cars, they look great. The fans love them, and the drivers love the downfall. Oh, look at that!
Woo! What a late move by Mike Skeen in that Hawk Performance Audi. I didn't see that one coming at all. Well, he just laid one in there.
He did. He was having a quiet day, but he's come alive again.
Boy, he has, and I mean, that's going to move him up, obviously, into a fairly key spot here. But the problem is, in terms of that Manufacturers Championship, you can see there's Johnny hanging on here over
Butch,
but up in front of them is Pilgrim, and that's the story way up and clear right now of Skeen in the highest placed Audi.
That is the key, and we saw this battle here yesterday. It was for the two podium positions that they were fighting for yesterday. They're off that right now, but certainly Butch will want to try and get as far through this field as he can. But I have to talk about Mike Skeen. He's done a tremendous job. Remember that the CRP group didn't get that Audi until Long Beach. They had to work on finding the right setup for the race car that would suit Mike Skeen. Went on to get three victories. So even if the titles don't go their way today, they've got to be very proud on this season.
Absolutely.
Oh, look at this.
Look at this move by Leitziger. That'll give him the inside on O'Connell. He's through.
Just worked him over, and Johnny didn't fight too hard there.
No. I think he knew. I mean, Leitziger had that position, didn't he? And that could only end up with him off.
I think everything's settling down to the right picture that he and Cadillac are looking for, so he doesn't want to do anything that's going to really ruffle anyone's feathers.
No, but look at Lazaro coming up on Skeen. Skeen not giving him room, but he gave him enough. There was enough room for a Ferrari and a couple of pieces of paper between the car and the inside of the track, and Lazaro took it. What a great cat and mouse game these two are playing.
No one has given up. No one has given an inch. I mean, Lazaro realized that third spot in the championship is still up for grabs.
Here's your leaders right now. Thorne under huge pressure from Dial and Baldwin in front of Aschenbach, now to second. We are taking you to the final checkered flag of the 25th anniversary season of the Pirelli World Challenge at the Nissan Championship Finale at Miller Motorsports Park, brought to you by Motul There is Johnny O'Connell, but he is feeling a heap of pressure from a Bentley, from a Ferrari, from an Audi. This is awesome stuff. And coming up, Andy Lee is booking, folks.
He really is. He has cleared Andrew Palmer as a man on a mission right now, trying to chase down this group. Pretty cool.
Yeah, I mean, take a look at this. You've got five cars, five different manufacturers here, absolutely at war for the fourth spot in this final race of the championship. And it is amazing stuff right now onto the front straight. And Johnny O, I don't know how much longer he can hang on, well, but he's Butch, doing everything he can.
Yeah, Butch really set him up there, and he's got inside him now. So it's going to be a drag race down this front straightaway, and then hard into our Mutual brake zone. I think Butch has got it.
And the one thing you know that Johnny's not is going to do is if it's a hard scrap, he'll let him slide through. Andy Pilgrim's way up there. They're concerned about this manufacturer challenge. You see that little bit of bodywork flapping on the side of Skeen's car? That can't be helping him down this long straight either.
Well, certainly not. The aerodynamic efficiency of the race car is so critical on any straightaway, particularly this one at two-thirds of a mile long. So going to be getting some drag there, literally.
Boy, Guy Smith, obviously, working hard in this battle as well. But that's a phenomenal lineup of machinery coming up here as we hop on board once again with Lazaro, who's seen Butch go through now. He knows it's conceivable. Let's see if he's able to get anything done. He is so close, Cal. Here he comes.
He looked to the inside on Johnny O. Johnny O runs a little bit of a higher line there. We saw that earlier in the race. And right now, that was pretty easy. So it looked like Johnny O was just saying, okay, guys, I think he'll have the picture painted to him over the radio from his team in terms of what he needs to do, and he's going to let some of these guys just battle around championship. For Lazaro, every point is important, but right now he looks like he would secure the third spot in the championship the way it runs right now. Yeah. Pilgrim, if he suddenly should win this race, well, that's a game changer, but right now he's not close to that lead duo.
Yeah, and I think for Johnny O, obviously this is the guy who's going after Pilgrim in terms of that third place in the championship, but the last thing you want to do is be accused of blocking. Remember, he said if he gets points taken from is the only way he could possibly lose this.
Right.
So he's going to be very, very careful about all of that. We go back to this battle for the lead, and again, as the white flag comes out, one more lap. Can the young Robert Thorne hang off on in front of the amazingly quick and talented Ryan Dial? He sure looks pretty good.
Well, if Ryan Dial has a trick up his sleeve, he's just got 14 more corners to use it on, and I think the hairpin is probably his best opportunity. But McLaren looks really well balanced. I think Robert Thorne has done a great job of managing those Pirelli tires, not using them up too badly here, defending from Ryan Dial. He's got to get through this fast left-hander cleanly. Looks like he's done so, so he should be in a good spot, maybe just to defend the line a little bit here. Don't really tempt Ryan down to the inside.
Well, the other side of it is the Porsches are known for their brakes, but that McLaren is getting pretty deep into these corners.
Yeah, I mean, Robert's just really done a phenomenal job. I mean, this season, he's really starting to come on form, and now two podiums so far this season, led yesterday, and he's led really from the start at drop of the green here today with Guy Smith's issues from the pole.
But he's got traffic that they're coming up. It's GT machinery, so he's not going to run into him as fast as he would GTS stuff, but we've seen traffic play a massive role many times this season. Yeah, isn't it?
When you look for the first win, that pressure is immense, and he's just got to try and hang on there. CDL working him over. He's looking for just getting a little bit better slingshot. This traffic is key. That's Janssen's car up ahead. They've got to clear that.
They both knife through. Janssen staying out, but I mean, Dial carrying a little bit more exit speed. He's coming up. Now we've got those two cars in front.
He looks
to
the inside.
Dial taking a big look, and Thorne senses it, Cal.
Oh, and he's running a little bit wide. Thorne is a little bit off apex, but there's nowhere for Dial to go. Dial needs to try and tuck it underneath, but Thorne's doing a great job. Will they keep it clean?
Here we go, last turn, Travic Thorne. He's got to check up a little bit behind the Audi. Dial gets a free run onto the straight, but he's going to run right up behind the Audi. Thorne using that machine as a pick. Nowhere for Dial to go, and Thorne gets it. But again, by a matter of feet, Calvin.
That was sensational stuff. And all credit to Ryan Dial. He kept it clean there. He could have traded paint a little bit, try and just get Robert to lose some momentum. He didn't do that. So great job to Robert with the win. But also hats off to Ryan Dial. A great runner-up position.
On board here now with Lawson Aschenbach. Now, Jack Baldwin is in front of that lead duo. He's got to do another lap, but that pretty much gives him the win. But Aschenbach comes through second place. That is enough. Aschenbach repeats as champion as here comes Baldwin now coming around. Damage to the back of Jeff Reeves' car, but Baldwin comes around. He will pick up. That's the official win. But Aschenbach in second, repeats as champion as well. You look back a few races, nobody would have believed that was happening either.
That's right, and here we look at the official results. Great win for Robert Thorne, his first in GT competition. Pilgrim secures third spot on the podium, but it's not enough to overtake Lazaro in the championship.
Nope, you take a look, there's Tim Pappas. After falling out of the lead in round 15, he hangs on to win it over Han. Michael Mills will clinch the championship. Another great run for Alex Welch. And there you take a look. Alex Figge, problems again after showing some good pace again. A frustrating season for Alex. But as he says before, I'm driving a McLaren. Life's not boring. Jack Baldwin with the win. That should give him second in the championship too, Cal.
Yeah, it's a shakeup, just like we saw at the final round at Houston last year between Baldwin, Aschenbach, and Wilkins, but Aschenbach on top both years now.
And Kozarov dropping back. They reported a loss of power. They think it was electrical late in the race, so problems for him, and there's Wilkins. I'll tell you, it's a tough study for those two Kias here this weekend. But for this young man, Robert Thorne hangs on for an amazing win over one of the best in the business, and he picks up the checkered flag, the Capex crew, their first win of the season, and here's our winner.
It was an incredible race, an incredible battle. I wasn't sure if I'd get the opportunity that I had yesterday to get the jump, get up into the lead of the race, and from then it was management, and then DL started coming on so strong. And it was about 10 laps after he kept pushing me that I started to think, well, maybe I can hold him off for this whole race. And he has a very strong car, but our package was pretty strong too.
Well, great day for him, but surreally for Johnny O'Connell this weekend, produced his third consecutive championship. He celebrated a bit earlier. Now he's in victory circle with Jeff Lepper.
You know, it's everybody at Cadillac, you know, management there, everybody at Cadillac Racing. Awesome teammate, Andy Pilgrim was on fire today. So, you know, we all pulled together, and I could not be more proud. You know, he stuck me with a killer move going into five. There was nothing I could do. But, you know, he drove great, and, you know, again, it's us working together as a team, and that's what we are.
Tell us about your career, man. Three here for Pirelli World Challenge. All that you've done, it's got to be pretty special.
Yeah, this one probably the most special. You know, I mean, we had a lot of challenges that we needed to overcome, but, you know, this team and Andy and myself, we executed. And, you know, we did not make a mistake all season long. And that's really what I'm most proud of. You know, these guys behind us. You know, a great team. And, you know, Andy and I, we're just the quarterbacks. You know, if you don't have a great team around you, if you don't have great Pirelli tires, and, of course, you know, the Cadillac CTSV, amazing hot rod, and Andy and I were two lucky guys.
Boy, that they are, and let's not forget, Andy Pilgrim was on fire this weekend and clinched that championship for Audi, but O'Connell gets the driver's championship. Mike Skeen came in with such opportunity.
He did, and he'll be disappointed, but for Johnny, 0-3 in a row, amazing stuff. I mean, I've never seen him drive better.
Our GTA driver's points presented by BRM Chronographs. Michael Mills gets the first ever Sportsman's Cup for our Sportsman's Class driver. Henrik Hedman gave him a good run all year over Knox, Marcello Hahn, and Jeff Courtney. And here is a look at the celebrations there for the effort crew, clinching that first ever Sportsman's Cup. And Jeff Lepper has now found Mike Mills.
Championship, but that's got to feel good.
Yeah, for sure it does. I'm really glad to get that first championship for effort racing. It means a lot to me, my family, everybody at MSR Houston. It's a big deal. We're really, really stoked. I needed a new watch this year. This one I've had 10 years, so I'm glad to get the new one.
Yeah, he's been a big fan of this series. He's loving it. But here's the story, Cadillac winning the championship as we take a look at our GT Manufacturers points presented by Nissan by five. And now, this is the moment when Jack Baldwin in the Reset MD racing for Kelsey Porsche went by a stricken Nick Janssen. That gave him his third win and second in the championship. He's with Jeff.
I can't thank the crew, the Reset MD, StopTech, Motec, Motul, and all my sponsors. Man, it was a hard race today. We got a little robbed yesterday. We had a good car yesterday, but I was so thankful to come back and get it done today and win it for the guys, win it for the crew who have worked so hard this year. You know, we've had a tough, tough season, and these guys have worked around the clock many, many times. And, oh, man, to finish on a high note and get back in second place, to come back from where we came from, it's an awesome day for us. I want to thank everybody. We have an awesome race team, Goldcrest Motorsports, and all the guys on our team, Buzz McCall, everybody that puts in is just fantastic.
Absolutely it is, and I'll tell you what, though, you watch this. That is the teammate pushing an out-of-fuel Lawson Aschenbach into victory circle and into a championship. Again, who'd have thunk this would happen? He's now with Jeff.
Man, this one almost feels sweeter than all of them because, you know, we knew this year coming in it was going to be a tough year with the way everything was kind of played out last year and the bounce performance and so forth. And,
you know, we just kept digging, you know, and that's kind of like our whole story for this whole year is we kept digging, we kept our heads up no matter what happened. We've had a lot of adversity, and in the end, we got it done. So I can't say thanks enough to Team Chevy, to Black Dog Speed Shop. This Camaro was awesome all year. I'm so proud to drive it. I'm so proud of these guys, and they deserve it more than I do. So I'm just so happy right now.
And as we take a look at those GTS driver's points, Aschenbach gets his second consecutive championship, I think fourth total, over Baldwin, who does get by Wilkins.
Yeah, it's just a big shakeup there. All three came in at the championship finale last year, and there's a shakeup there, another one today.
GTS manufacturer points presented by Kia goes to Kia. The future, well, the potential is virtually unlimited for a season that is on the move. We look forward to seeing you next March at Circuit of the Americas. For Cal Fish and Jeff Lepper, I'm Greg Creamer. See you then, folks.